Currently, all the list items have the same layout. However, we want the today item to use a different layout, which we defined earlier in the list item forecast today XML file. This is where adapter item view types will save the day. This is a general concept for all adapters, not just cursor adapter. Instead of just knowing about one item view type, which yields the same layout for all list items, the adapter can declare multiple item view types, so it will have different list item layouts. For a given row in the cursor, the forecast adapter needs to decide if it should be a regular list item or a today list item. Then it will inflate and bind data for the appropriate layout. We'll jump into the forecast adapter code now to learn how to handle a second item view type. Normally in the subclass, getViewTypeCount returns 1, but we're going to override it so it returns 2 for the two different layouts. But how does it know when to use one layout or the other? Well, we override getItemViewType so that when the position in the list is 0, then we say that it's the today view type. Otherwise, it's the future day view type. These two view types are declared up above. These are just integer representations of the view type. The numbering has to start at 0 because these values cannot be greater than or equal to getViewTypeCount. So the possible values for us are 0 and 1, so that we know that 0 always maps to the view type today and that 1 always maps to view type future day. We're going to use this information in the new view method. Remember that previously we inflated the list item forecast XML. Now we're going to use the item view type to determine whether we should use one layout or the other. Fill in the to-do to address this behavior. Layout ID refers to resource ID, which is in the form of r.layout.something.